Jessica's right. At the World Series, the president threw out the pitch. It was good. But I must tell you, the record shows that when George W. Bush, as president of the United States, threw out his first pitch for a ball game, it was a bouncer. So there. Let's see how he does tonight. Joining us now is Evan Weiner, who's a commentator on the business of sports. Evan, welcome.
Hi, Sam. How you doing?
Well, fine. I commented that Bob Short moved the old Washington Senators, which was the second Senators. Calvin Griffin had moved them before that in 1971 because he thought he couldn't make any money in this town. So what's changed so that this new team you think can make money if you do?
Well, a lot has changed. First, you have a metro in Washington, so people could actually get to the game. But also, the whole packaging of baseball has changed. There's cable TV markets now. There weren't any cable TV stations carrying baseball games in 1971. And if they were, they weren't paying team owners money. The national TV contract is a lot more than it was in 1971. Marketing is totally different than in 1971. Baseball sells its logos. In fact, Peter Uberoth, about 15 years ago, told me the most important aspect of a baseball team was to protect its logo, not its players. So there's a lot of money coming in from logos, from TV, from luxury boxes, from club seats. When the Senators left in 1971, there were no club seats and there were no luxury boxes. In Washington's case, the metro is going to make a tremendous difference.
Okay, you've laid out some of the reasons why there is a big difference, and I agree with you. But let's look at the overall question of whether this opening day, of course, will produce tens of thousands of people at RFK. Over the next few months or years, do you think it'll fall off? Baseball has had a tough time nationally in the last couple of decades.
Well, the novelty wears off unless you have a winning team. If you have a winning team, people are going to come to see you. They will have a new ballpark eventually, maybe 2 years, maybe 3 years, it may be 4 years, and that will bring people in. But if you look in Philadelphia, they're going into a third season in that park, and they're going to get less than 5,000 people per game than they did when they opened the park. You better win. That's the bottom line. If you're not going to win, people are not going to go see you play. That's the problem. That was partially part of the problem with the old Washington Senators.
Evan, Geoff Morrell here in Washington.
Hi, Geoff.
You alluded to the issue of the TV revenue. Much has been made, as you well know, about the TV deal that Peter Angelos, the owner of the Baltimore Orioles, has cut with Major League Baseball and the future owner of the Nationals. And a lot of people say it is very skewed towards Angelos and the Orioles. There are others, including the mayor of Washington, who wrote an editorial today in the Washington Post saying, not so fast. Actually, the Nationals may have got the best end of this deal. What's your take on it?
Well, it's going to be hard to figure out until we see what Comcast does. Comcast is the cable TV company that's most prominent in the mid-Atlantic states, and they're going to have to cut a deal with Brian Roberts over at Comcast to see whether he wants the Nationals or not. You got to remember the Orioles are partners with Comcast right now, and Roberts is the most important guy in terms of local cable TV in sports. There's no deal with Comcast right now. That has to evolve. You're going to have to get an owner into Washington and work out a deal with Angelos. Angelos claims all the territory in Baltimore and south to Washington, and he's going to lose a ton of money if baseball doesn't allow Baltimore to put its games into Northern Virginia and D.C. It's still early. It's still very early to see what happens in 2008. When the Orioles contract with Comcast is done and the Orioles and Nationals have to coexist under a baseball network. As of right now, there are games in Washington, but Washington's going to need about $30 million to compete. You got to remember, the Yankees get more than $50 million a year that could go into player payroll. The Mets are starting a network next season. The White Sox and the Cubs are sharing in the network. The Houston Astros are starting a network. That's where the money is. Sure, there's money in the stands with revenues coming from club seats and luxury boxes, but the real revenue in baseball and the real revenue divide is with TV. That's why Pittsburgh is failing. That's why the Yankees compete every year. Pittsburgh doesn't get that TV money. If Washington,
but Evan, as I understand the TV deal, 90% of the regional sports network will be owned by Angelos, 10% for the Nationals owners, which at first glance looks like a bad deal for them. But when you take into account that there's no guarantee this thing will succeed, and therefore the Nationals have no risk involved, in addition they've cut a deal according to this contract that they get a guaranteed $21 million from Major League Baseball, which puts them in very good stead among their competitors. It looks as though, when you take a closer look at this thing, as though the Nationals are going to be in good shape TV-wise, at least economically at first?
Well, maybe at first, but they're going to have to compete with the New York Yankees, who own the YES Network, the New York Mets, who are going to own their network, the Boston Red Sox, who own the NESN Network, Houston Astros, the Chicago Cubs, and the White Sox, and those are cash cows. When you own your own network, that's a cash cow. If Washington is only getting $21 million a year, that's only the middle of the pack. And middle of the pack doesn't mean you're going to compete every year. You need that TV money.
Evan Weiner, thank you very much for joining today and talking about the Washington Nationals on opening day.
Thank you, Sam.
Evan Weiner of the business of sports is what he does, a national commentator. Well, Geoff, you know, the old joke about the old Washington Senators was first in war, first in peace, last in the American League. The new Washington Nationals.